Welcome to the Temporary Price Reductions, or TPRs, training module of the FAS Catalog Platform, or FCP, Vendor Training Series. In this module, we will discuss how to create a TPR action, how to establish sales, how to update existing sales, how to cancel existing sales, how to perform all three sale actions in a single TPR catalog action, and when and how the TPR catalog action publishes to Advantage. The baseline products catalog action clears out all existing sales from GSA Advantage. A new sale can be established as soon as the baseline products action is approved and published to Advantage. The FCP TPR catalog action requires that the vendor first link an open, applicable EMOD modification prior to creating the TPR action in FCP. Establishing, updating, and canceling sales can be performed within the same EMOD modification. Submitting a modification for the TPR ensures that the contract has a record of the sale. This is a requirement for all pricing changes, but was not previously enforced by SIP. To ensure sales are reflected on Advantage quickly, FCP begins publishing TPRs as soon as the vendor presses the Submit button in EMOD, while the modification is still pending CSCO review in FSS Online. Here, we see a validation message indicating we need to first create a modification in EMOD, as there are currently no modifications that we can link. The vendor navigates to the contract in EMOD to create an applicable modification type. For the FCP TPR action, the only applicable modification type is temporary price reduction, which we will select and create here. Once the modification is created, an EMOD ID generates. In this case, our modification ID ends in 4TU, which we can now link to our FCP action. The vendor can either navigate directly back to FCP or can press the Go to FCP button in the EMOD Modifications Upload Documents section. Back on the Create New Catalog Action page, the vendor can now select the TPR Action Radio button and click the EMOD ID drop-down menu to expand a list of all applicable modifications. Here, we will select the TPR modification we just created, ID ending in 4TU. TPRs are only meant for products published to GSA Advantage, so there is no field asking where the products will be sold. Press the Continue button to create the catalog action. To start the TPR catalog action, the vendor should download the currently approved catalog product file to work with the product data currently available on GSA Advantage. The TPR product file should only include products where you are providing sale information. So we will remove the products from this product file that we do not need to modify. When establishing a sale, FCP validates on the following fields in the product file: item type, manufacturer name, manufacturer part number, sale price with fee, start date, and stop date. Other fields can remain in the product file, but any changes to other fields will be ignored for processing and publishing. Only one TPR can be established per item. Entering future sale information in the TPR fields will replace and remove any existing sales for that product. Here, I will enter sale information for the three TPR fields for this product. vendors can only update sales that already exist on the catalog. The same fields from our Establish a Sale modification are required to update an existing sale. Here, we will update the sale timeframe for this product, extending the stop date from July 15th, 2023 to August 15th, 2023. Vendors can only cancel sales that already exist on the catalog. To cancel a sale, only the following fields are required in the product file: item type, manufacturer name, and manufacturer part number. Leave the three TPR fields blank to cancel the sale. Here, we will delete the sale information for this product to remove the sale from GSA Advantage. New sales, updates to existing sales, and cancellations can all be combined into one product file and one TPR catalog action, as long as the TPR updates are for unique products. Update several products at once to quickly publish your TPR updates to Advantage. In this example, our product file is establishing a new sale for a product, updating an existing sale for another, and canceling a currently running sale for a third product. Once this TPR action publishes to Advantage, all three products listed here will have their sale information updated on GSA Advantage. After adding sale information to the product file and saving the file, the vendor uploads the product file to the FCP catalog action. Upload the file to stage it, and press the Send Files to EMOD button to submit the file through for automated data and business rule validation. As validation checks are performed, the action status updates automatically. If a user role is not specified in the action status label, then this means no action is needed by the user, and the system will automatically progress through its processing in the background. If the product file fails data or business rule validation, then an error report will be generated for the vendor to review and take action on. See the product file and error remediation training module for more information regarding this process. The page can be refreshed to view the updated status. If the product file passes the validation checks, then the action status updates to sending to EMOD, as seen here. The FCP system is working to send the product file to the associated EMOD modification. Once this file transfer is complete, the action status updates to requires vendor action, submit to CSCO in EMOD. At this point, no further action in FCP is needed. The vendor should return to EMOD to submit the modification. Similar to the delete action, CSCO review is not required in order to publish our catalog action. So once the vendor submits the modification in EMOD, the automated publishing process to Advantage will begin. After logging into EMOD, we can locate our TPR modification and press the Edit Mod button. The vendor completes the required sections and can verify the product file sent from FCP by downloading the file that displays in the Upload Documents section. When ready, submit the modification in EMOD. EMOD will still send the modification to FSS online for the CSCO to review and officially award the modification, but approval is not needed to publish our sale change to Advantage. After the vendor submits the modification in EMOD, the FCP TPR catalog action shows as pending publishing on Advantage. This automated publishing process can take 1 to 2 business days to complete, and once successfully published, the vendor receives an email notification, and the FCP action status updates to published on Advantage. Time for a knowledge check. How does a vendor cancel a sale? Do they submit a product file with the products currently on sale and leave all TPR fields blank? Submit a product file with the products currently on sale and make all TPR fields be past dates? Call VSC support and ask them to cancel it? Or can a vendor not cancel a sale and they must wait for it to run out naturally? Vendors can cancel a sale by submitting a product file with the products currently on sale and by leaving all TPR fields blank. True or false? Only one TPR can be established per item. Entering future sale information in the TPR fields will remove any existing sales for these products. The answer is true. Submitting new TPR dates will overwrite any existing sales. This concludes the TPR training module. Thank you for watching.